Hi everyone, good morning. Welcome to the chemistry online class. How are you children? Hope all are doing well. Children, today let's begin with a new chapter, chapter 14, water. We all know about water, isn't it? Water is precious, fundamental, and the most essential substances required for the existence of life on earth. Water is found naturally, abundantly in our planet Earth. About 2/3 of our Earth total surface is covered with water. What is water? Water is transparent, colorless, tasteless inorganic molecule composed of hydrogen and oxygen, as the chemical formula of water is H2O. Water is an inexhaustible, important natural resource. So we can say water is life. Now let's see how much of water availability in our planet Earth. Let's see the availability of water on the Earth. About 97% of water on the Earth is salty and is present in the oceans and seas. Only 3% of water is clean, out of which 2% of water is frozen in the form of ice caps in the glaciers, polar regions and mountain peaks. Only 1% of water on the earth is available to us for our use in the form of underground water, lakes, tanks, rivers and streams. So in general, we can say that 97% of Earth's water is salt water. 3% is fresh water. Out of this 3%, 2% of fresh water is frozen and unavailable. And 1% is fresh water and for our use. Out of this 1%, 1/3 is groundwater. Next is uses of water. We all use water for different purposes, which includes everyday household uses, including drinking. Drinking water is also called as potable water. Potable means water which is suitable for drinking. Water is also used for cooking, bathing, cleaning, washing, brushing teeth, gardening, for agricultural applications, industrial requirements, etc. Thus, water is required for many activities. Therefore, it is an essential element required for the continuity of life on Earth. Moving on to the sources of water. We know that 75% of the total Earth surface is covered with water. Out of these, only a small percentage, about 2-3%, is suitable for human use. The other 97% or 98% available are found in ocean, seas, rivers, ponds, glaciers, etc. So let's see what are the important sources of water.
The main sources of water we get from rainwater, groundwater and surface water. Rainwater is a major component of the water cycle. It deposits most of the fresh water on the earth. Surface water is the water above the ground. It includes streams, lakes, ponds, seas and oceans, etc. Surface water shall be consumed only after it has been properly filtered and disinfected. Another source of water is groundwater. During the rain, some water seeps into the ground, which is called underground water. Groundwater is the water present beneath the earth surface. And groundwater can be consumed using well, tube wells, hand pump, etc.
Moving on to the next important topic in this chapter, that is water cycle. You might have learned in your lower classes about water cycle. What is water cycle? The continuous journey of water in nature from earth to clouds and back to earth is called water cycle. The water cycle consists of many processes. Let's see what are the processes involved in water cycle.
As you know, there is a lot of water in the earth, mainly in ponds, lakes, oceans, even in plants. So, when the sun shines and it becomes hot, the water from the ponds, lakes and oceans turns into water vapor. This process is called evaporation. That is water turning into water vapor because of heat. The leaves of the plants also lose water from their surface because of the sun's heat. When water in the leaves becomes water vapor, it is called transpiration. All these vapors are very light and they rise high up in the sky where they turn into small droplets of water because of cold temperature. This is called condensation. Millions of water droplets come together to form a cloud. Within the cloud, they keep bumping into each other to make bigger water drops. When the cloud becomes very heavy because of these drops, it lets them fall on the ground in the form of rain or snow. This is called precipitation. These water drops, which we call rain, falls in the oceans, lakes and ponds, and some part of it also goes under the earth, which is called percolation. So the rainwater gets collected. The sun shines again, the water gets heated again, the clouds form again, and the rain happens again. Just like a cycle goes round and round, the water cycle also goes round and round. So the continuous journey of water in the nature from earth to clouds and back to the earth is called water cycle. It includes evaporation, condensation and precipitation.
So I hope all of you understood what is water cycle. Today we learned about the availability of water on earth, uses of water, sources of water and water cycle. So let's wind up this class. I have attached a corresponding video URL, test question and notes. Copy the notes and read the lessons well. See you in the next class. Thank you, children.